it's so much a part of my identity at this point. It's something that I do so much of the time, and I've made a lot of these all these records and toured for 10 years that, you know, I'm still sort of, I still play in this band, I'm still involved with this music whether I'm doing it or not, and you can sort of almost start to take that for granted, and then when we finally go back out on the road, it comes to life again, mm-hmm. and you realize the whole reason that you're thinking about this all the time, and people are reminding you of it, and saying, oh, such and such. And
this it's like, you know, I mean, we all know we can all play, and we do other projects,
we play with other people.
Do other things, and it's, you know, it's fun, but every time, we've talked about this too, there's this thing, we start to play these songs, and suddenly there's this other thing. Well, it's the group thing that is something that's evolved over lots of years.
Dude, it's hard to put into words. It's a kind of, I mean, I've always thought that music kind of has its own logic and syntax and vocabulary, and you sort of think in music.
Uh-huh.
You know, you frame thoughts in musical terms, and it would take far longer to express, you know, in words, the thought that happens in the split second that makes you decide to play that. But it is a kind of, you know, it is a kind of thinking. It's just in that,
yeah.
in that world. But I think about, you know, music, music.
So the best thing to do is just kind of just listen, you know. I just try to dream when I play. And, you know, you try to hear everybody and you try to control yourself. But for me, it's best when I'm playing, when my body is moving in like a rhythm.
Mm-hmm.
And then it just sort of does what it does, and I'm kind of like central command control, and I kind of just help it along. But you know, it's that other thing where you think, oh, I've got it, man, it sounds great, all of a sudden before you know it, oops, you know. So,
you know, the frustrating thing is every now and then you actually do get it right.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it might be it's like every fourth night or every tenth night or every 6 months or once a year, but
right.
every now and then you do it.
Yeah.
And that makes it worse almost, because right. it's like you know you can do it. You know that you're not crazy.
Right.
It's there. There is a truth there that can be found. And I think each year that you play, you become more consistent at
right.
or you get closer to that truth that,
right.
that you establish in your mind. But as you get closer to it, it also moves at the same rate
right.
higher
right.
away from where
right.
you are.
So, just like this is a shorter. These are flat rides. Pat, you know, really likes like a short, crisp thing. I do a lot of, you know. So instead of, it kind of washes out, this is all this, you know? So you have two different pitches. This is sort of just an override symbol, like when you're really like on the out course and you really want to hit it hard,
right.
you got this.
Right.
This is just for, you know, the Chinese symbol just for bashing the hell out of, you know?
Where did they come from? Did they come from Trinidad? The drums?
I have no idea to tell you the truth.
From a music store here in Boston.
Is that right? Like in Arlington?
Estava na Paris.
Oh, estava.
Hoje, estou chegando de Paris. Tocando com Jim Hall.
Jimmy Hall?
Yes.
Estava bom. Estava bom?
Yeah. There's a way to keep it like this.
Yeah.
Freshness.
Yeah.
You know, like that you haven't heard it for like a year and a half.
Take a year and a half off between gigs.
Every gig.
They don't work much, but damn, they're fresh.